Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome to a special Easter weekend edition of NoDQ&A Video right here on NoDQ.com and the YouTube channel, as well as NoDQ&A Video's affiliate, RingsideNews.com. Got your questions here from spring.me/AaronRift. So let's get started here with the first one today from one of our favorites, WWE fan Dark Arrow. Hey Aaron, with Cody Rhodes not being featured like he used to, do you see him getting a main event push still? I want him to because he is a good talent and WWE needs new top guys. I think that Cody Rhodes is in a bad spot right now, and I think a lot of guys that have been around the WWE for several years now that haven't really gotten to the main event level, I think that it's going to be tough for them in the future, and here's why. Let's start off with Cody Rhodes. He has had several runs in WWE. First, he was teaming up with Ted DiBiase and part of Legacy, and then he became Dashing Cody Rhodes, and then he had the mask, and now he's been teaming up with his brother Goldust. But Cody Rhodes has really never gotten past that mid-card to upper-card level. And the fact of the matter is that right now in WWE, they are looking at new talent. They are looking at guys from NXT, and going forward, WWE has new guys that they are focusing on, guys like The Shield, guys like Cesaro, and people that WWE were pushing a few years ago. They're going to, unfortunately, be pushed aside. And that's one of the big problems with the situation and the wrestling landscape right now, where WWE is essentially a monopoly. It's the only major league promotion in the United States. Yes, you have TNA, and then you have Ring of Honor and the other indie promotions, but there's just not a lot of room for these guys to go around, and you have a lot of people that are trying to make it in WWE, and you have a very limited amount of spots. So when WWE starts to push new talent, you have guys like Cody Rhodes, Kofi Kingston, and so on that get lost in the shuffle. And that's just the unfortunate reality of the current wrestling landscape. And moving on here, I got a lot of questions about various guys that are in the mid-card right now. Do you think that with Damian Sandow on Raw going out there and saying what was on the IWC's mind about him, do you see this being a gimmick for him? I don't think it's going to amount to anything, to be honest with you. Remember several weeks back when The Miz came out and The Miz was appearing to be very disgruntled, and it seemed like WWE was going to do this storyline with The Miz and maybe him forming a faction with other guys that are being held back. It never really went anywhere. And I don't think WWE and the creative team know what to do with Damian Sandow at this point. And it's just really unfortunate. Also going back to The Miz, a guy who at one point headlined WrestleMania, and now look at him. He's just another guy on the roster. And Damian Sandow was a Money in the Bank winner, and he's just doing jobs now every week on television. So with WWE focusing on other people, it's hard to say that guys like Damian and Cody and Kofi Kingston and The Miz, I just don't know if there's going to be much of a future for these guys besides just being bodies. Maybe if they're lucky, they'll get another opportunity. And this one comes from Captain Heisenberg. Hey Aaron, it frustrates me how Big E has been booked since the Royal Rumble. He had a lot of momentum, then he got lost in the shuffle and now stooped to being eliminated by Fandango in a battle royal. Do you think he can recover and become a future top star? There's always a possibility, as I just said, that maybe Big E or one of these guys can get lucky and get another opportunity. But when there's so many people competing for a very limited amount of top spots, it's really difficult. And once you've lost that opportunity, once you've got that push, it's hard to get another chance when WWE wants to focus on somebody new and somebody different. Big E, I mean, he does have friends in high places. John Cena's a guy that's been vouching for him, so maybe he'll get another opportunity. And another problem is that guys get hurt. I mean, we've seen it with Fandango. We've seen it with Dolph Ziggler with the concussion. Guys get a push and then they get hurt. They lose their spot, and then it's very difficult to get that spot back. So as far as Big E goes, he's got the size. So, I mean, that's something that's working for him that a lot of the other guys don't have. And, you know, he might get another opportunity at some point. I mean, he's still the IC champion as of this video. But, you know, that doesn't mean much in this day and age. And in all likelihood, he's going to end up losing the title at Extreme Rules. So I don't know what's going to happen with Big E after that. And, you know, it's just the sign of the times that all these guys, they get their chances. And WWE is very quick to push a guy, and then if they don't catch on right away, they give up on them and then move on to the next guy. And then the fact of the matter is that WWE has seemingly an endless supply of next guys. Once one guy doesn't work, you can toss him aside and work on the next guy and see if you can get him over. So, you know, that's just the reality here in the world of WWE right now. And here we go with another one from ClarkyBoy123. Why do you think Wade Barrett is getting a push all of a sudden, and how long do you think it will last? Well, here's an example of a guy who is appearing to get a second chance. Wade Barrett did get his initial push in NXT during that first season. He was the winner, and you know, he formed Nexus, and he was in a main event at the Survivor Series pay-per-view against Randy Orton with Cena as the referee. And then he kind of just got lost in the shuffle, and now he's starting to get another push. You know, the Bad News Barrett gimmick, you know, I wasn't really feeling it at first, but it has caught on to a degree, and the way he says the phrase, and, you know, it's something that has stuck with people, and I think that has helped him. It's just something that caught on. I don't know if people expected it to catch on. I think they were just throwing it out there and seeing if it would stick. And it did stick. And now he's finally getting in the ring. And we'll see what happens with him. Barrett is another guy like Big E that has an advantage in the fact that he's tall, he's big, and he has a good look. So, you know, that will help him for sure. All right, this one comes from The Naked Ninja. Hair, do you think that WWE will stop giving part-timers the main event of WrestleMania no matter how much they draw with their name because of the fans' loyalty to full-time stars? I don't think that WWE will stop pushing part-timers if those part-timers can draw and bring in people. WWE is a business first and foremost, and if bringing back a part-timer is best for WWE's business, regardless of what the internet fans say, WWE is going to bring those guys back. And it's kind of funny, too, because a lot of times fans are like, please bring back The Rock, or please bring back Sting, or please bring back Goldberg. And then these guys come back, and then the fans complain and say, you know, these guys are taking up the spots that the younger guys would have had, and you know, they're stealing the spotlight from them. So, you know, fans can be hypocritical at times. And sometimes it's justified, sometimes it's not. With The Rock, you know, he came back and he did record business. And when WWE makes more money, the talent roster makes more money. So it's best for everybody if business is up. So, you know, anybody that criticized The Rock, I mean, the guy was bringing in money for WWE. And then that's what's most important at the end of the day. All right, this one comes from Manuel Cernes. Hey Aaron, longtime listener, first time asker. Realistically speaking, who was the worst draw as world champion, JBL or Diesel? What about Jack Swagger and where does he rank? Well, a lot of people would say Diesel because Diesel was the champion and that was when WWE was at their absolute lowest period from a financial standpoint. You know, business was way down and Diesel wasn't moving the numbers. With JBL and especially Swagger, by the time JBL became champion, it didn't really matter who the WWE champion was because people go to the shows to see the SmackDown brand or they go to see the Raw brand. They're going to see the collective roster in one place, and they're not really going to see one specific person. When Diesel was the champion, it was still during a period where you know, there were individual draws, and the titles still had some value. So, you know, I think I would go with Diesel as the worst drawing champion, just because he was champion during that period when business was way down. And, you know, wouldn't say it was his fault or anything, but it was just the way things were. And, you know, Jack Swagger certainly didn't draw anything, but there aren't a lot of people that would have drawn in that position. definitely hurt the prestige of the title, and a lot of that had to do with the way he was booked as well. All right, final question here today. Oh, by the way, before I finish up here, let me just get a plug out. I am posting a series of retro blogs that I first wrote on MySpace back in the day. Some of these blogs are almost 10 years old. I'm reposting them on NoDQ's website. Go to nodq.com/columns and look for Retro Rift. I posted a bunch of my pay-per-view reviews, and I'll be posting more blogs from around 2005, 2006 with my thoughts. And just check that out, and tell a friend on Facebook and Twitter about No DQ&A Video. Keep spreading the word about No DQ&A Video. Now, before I go, got this final question here from Jondrix Romano. Hey, Aaron, do you see Eric Young losing the world title at Sacrifice? I think that there's a good chance that he will be a transitional champion, but it depends on what direction TNA wants to go. If they feel that Eric Young is getting momentum as world champion, he could end up staying champion for a while. But it could be a similar situation to Chris Sabin, where it was just done to pop a rating and try to generate some kind of buzz. And TNA definitely could have used the buzz. And, you know, they did get some buzz from Eric Young winning the title. And they got some people talking. So, I mean, in a sense, it did work to a degree. So we'll see what happens. If people keep rallying behind Eric Young and the numbers continue to stay decent, maybe he will be champion for an extended period of time. We'll just have to wait and see how things play out with that. So that'll do it for this edition of No DQ&A Video. I will see you guys next time for more.